When designing schematics, I love to break the entire schematics into components on a single schematics page. And this can be for the purpose of testing, understanding, or modularization. And this is possible because the components might come from individual data sheet reference circuits or other open source designs, and which means I can be pretty sure that it will work. But at other times, when I kind of bring together a few components, I am kind of not sure whether it will work. And this is exactly where using a circuit simulator can come in very, very handy. In today's video, we will look at one particular circuit simulator, which is easily shareable, web-based, and also completely free. It is called Falstad, built by Paul Falstad. To access the Falstad circuit simulator, we just need to go to falstad.com/circuit. And here you will already see that it comes with a default circuit and some explanatory texts at the bottom. One of the cool things that I like about this is that it also has standalone native application. Let's look at the Mac one, which I have already downloaded. It is called circuitjs.app, and when I open it on my machine locally, you will basically see the similar options and menu items like that of the web version. And this native app can come in really, really handy if we want to simulate a circuit totally offline. The other thing that I love to do, which is the first thing that I do, is to click on the full screen version. And this will basically bring me to the entire screen, which will have a lot more real estate for me to work on. And the last thing that I want to show you as part of the overview is that under the circuits menu, there are many, many basic circuits that you can try out and see for yourself. For example, under the basic, you might come across something called resistors, or even under the 555 timer chip, you can see a square wave generator with the scope and the simulation running right at the bottom. The next option that we should look at is probably the options menu. And over here, there are a couple of things that we should take note. First is the shortcuts. And this is where we can use the keyboard shortcuts to define easily accessible items such as adding a wire, resistor, capacitor, and etc. So I will basically leave them as default and we will use them later on. The next thing is also you can choose the white background depending on our personal preference. So I'm gonna just go ahead and choose a white background. And finally, we will come to the draw menu, which will basically give us all the components that we can put on the page and start a simulation. Before we start, let me just go ahead and select the entire example and then just hit delete to clear the page. Let's start exploring the circuit simulation by drawing a hello world of electronics, which is basically the LED circuit. And to do that, we will start by adding a resistor. So I'm going to just click R and I'm going to add a 1K resistor. And that let me add a switch, which can also be added with S. And we can use the shift command to drag it around as well. And what about, say, a battery? So that will be part of input and sources, a 2-terminal voltage source. So I'm going to rotate it. And of course, hit shift and move it. And finally, maybe an LED. I believe the LED has a shortcut of L, so I'm just going to press L and include an LED. And when we double click, we can have different types of LED. Maybe I'll just keep it as default LED and apply. And now with W, I'm going to just draw the wires. So to edit certain components, we can always double click. For example, if you want to change the resistance of this resistor, or if we also want to change, say, the voltage, I'll keep it at 5 volts. We can also do that. We can also press open and close the switch. But the cool thing about Falstad is that we can stop or start the simulation. So I'm going to start it. Of course, nothing is happening because the switch is completely open. And now I'm going to close it. And here you can see that something is running. Well, that is obviously the current speed, which when we can come right here on the right hand corner, and then we can change the current speed. So I'm going to stop the simulation, and you can see that the current is not running anymore. The next thing we should definitely explore is the menu for scopes. And as when we run the simulation, we should be able to see the scope graph. But before we do that, let me just delete this wire right here. And I am basically going to add an ammeter so that we can see the amount of current that will be passing through. So I'm going to put it right here. Of course, right now is 0 amperes. And next, I'm going to right click over here and then say view in scope. And immediately you see a graph will be displayed at the bottom. It will display both the voltage as well as the current. Of course, nothing is happening right now, but notice when we click start, you will see that the amps is showing here, and of course the LEDs lighted up, as well as the graph here is moving. And for the simulation, we can definitely increase the simulation speed, and notice the graph will be moving faster or slower based on our requirement. We can, of course, also change the simulation speed of the current. So once again, when we hover over the component, we should be able to see more details about the component right here beside the scope graph. And of course, when we open the switch, everything just goes to zero, including the voltage as well as the current. So now that we have created a circuit, one of the cool things of Falstad is that we can go and share this circuit with others. And we can do this in two ways. One is we can export it as a link. So when I click export link, we will see that a link with a lot of parameters in the URL is created. So when we copy it and then when we paste it in a new tab, we will be able to see exactly the same circuit. The other way is to export as text, and this will give us a bunch of really easy to read text, which is not really understandable though, but we can copy it. And if we open a new Falstad in the tab, we can import from text and then paste the text here. And when we click OK, we should get back exactly the same circuit. As a final example, let's look at a real application of this circuit simulator. For example, this is a schematic that I have built. And this part of the schematic was something I was not sure. Basically, it takes in power from USB micro B, or it can also take in power from battery, but of course not at the same time. Therefore, I have a bunch of diode and a P-channel MOSFET that I wanted to put in the simulator and try it out. So I've already made the circuit, so I can just go to file and import from text and paste the circuit text right here. And when I click, the schematic component of that circuit will appear in Falstad. So as you can see, I've made the two power sources here. These are the text that we can also add by going to output labels and then add text just for some explanation. And then I've also annotated the 1K resistor as a load, and this is the P-channel MOSFET. I've also added the scope right at the bottom. So let me start the simulation with a run, and you can see nothing is happening, but when I click the USB power on, you can see that the voltage is now 4.47. Of course, that's because the diode is about 500 millivolts, that's why. I also like that it shows the direction of the current, and notice what happens when I press the battery. So this is kind of good because of the diode and the P-channel MOSFET here, the power is not being drawn from the battery. But the moment I take out the USB power, you see that the battery current is running right now. And of course, the overall voltage will be slightly lower, 3.9 volts, because the battery is about 4.5 volts. And of course, if I take out the battery, the entire thing will go to zero. Now, there are other types of circuit simulators as well, and I would like to mention a couple. The first one is Circuit Lab, which is a time-limited paid version. And I kind of like it because it is very, very intuitive to use. And the second one is, of course, LT Spice with its entire suite of simulation and lots of tools that come with LT Spice. But I like to use LT Spice with, say, analog circuits. But I keep coming back to the Falstad circuit simulator for two main reasons. Number one, it is very, very accessible on the web, or you can also download it as the native application for Windows or Mac. And number two, because of the exporting as text or even as a web link with a lot of parameters, we can share that link on the internet and ask questions or get some feedback. So it makes it very, very accessible and easy to use for quick and dirty testing of our circuit components. So go ahead and give Falstad Circuit Simulator a try if you haven't already. And if you have, we should definitely be using the Falstad Circuit Simulator, the export function, and share our components with others to get feedback and get better at what we are doing. So thanks for watching and see you next time.